Welcome back to Let's Play Enderal. Forgotten Stories, Blind, I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Just outside Old Rationgrad. Lashari. Not Lashiri, I believe. Could not help us. And, it's just that there was something different about us. She called me strange. She's dead. So I have to return to the Sun Temple to report to Constantine Firespark. And, bear with me. I sound fine to myself, but I might be a little slurry with words or something like that, because I had dental work, basically, as we're speaking from my point of view, yesterday. So, I'm a little... What do you say? Not under the weather, but might not be at full strength here. I have 5 of these. Teleport to the Sun Temple. Why don't mind using it then? Let's go back to Constantine. Oh yes, and I did miss one fire. I think I got 7, it was actually 8. Oh, and now, beginning. Yes.
Ah, there you are. Magister Karis has been looking for you.
I thought she was talking to me.
Karis? Why's that?
I don't know. But I think it's about the time.
With this episode, now on a patch or version 1.5.8.0, I believe. So I just quickly glanced through the changes just to see if anything familiar. I breezed over everything else. The only thing I noticed is that
this just doesn't make any sense. Huh?
It'll all make sense. The only thing I noticed before he interrupts me.
Yeah, as if.
Is, what's the guy's name? Menhir? He rewarded me twice. He gave me 2 books. He gave me 1 book with, I believe it's 2.
Yes. Yes, it just might work.
It worked for me. 2 crafting points. Oh, I think it was 2 learning points. 2 extra learning points. And then when I went back to go check back to the farm to go check on what's his name and his daughter, and found them dead, I ran into Menhir again, and he gave me another book with 2 learning points. So it's been fixed. He only does it once. That's the only thing I noticed. I was basically just looking for quests I recognized the names of, and he's in here. Requires a key. Well, that's dreadfully inconvenient. Oh, it's late. He's probably sleeping. Can I bed down somewhere? Any beds up here? Bedrooms? Well, these things are so creepy looking, huh? Eek. I do not see beds. I mean, I know there's an area with beds. It's probably in a whole different... building? Another ward of this area? Guess so.
What?
Is that good? Is that some good bread?
Walk blessed.
Is that a yes? How dare this guy be asleep? Barrack quarter? Oh, that. That goes completely out of here. Probably off the path.
Greetings.
Thank you. Just as you guys know, you can't just wait around like in Skyrim. You have to sleep or just literally wait for time to go. In the game world, which could take quite a bit of time.
Walk blessed.
Thank you.
This is holy.
I want to sleep blessed. You do not belong here. I belong here. I don't think the curiarium has like coffins and stuff. It's not working. Doesn't work, man. They replaced the stuff in here. It says sleep, like you can actually use it to sleep, but you can't. Oh, that doesn't even open. Doesn't say why either. I forget which. Oh. Right, I remember now. Emporium? I forget which one had all the bedrooms, different bedrooms. It's basically what I'm looking for. Or just any other area which might have a bed. Sun temple. Well, this is just upstairs.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, it makes so much sense now. Oh my god. Why does this have to be so complicated?
Hello.
Hoi.
This is the ground, Outlander. You don't belong here.
I am most holy myself. I'm full of holes. Don't know what I'm talking about? Well, neither do I. I just need a bed. I'm tired and stuff. Dead end. Bless you. What if I just... Does this go outside? I have a feeling it goes outside. Free to take. Only four, though. Oh, well. Sanctum.
This is holy ground, Outlander.
Silence, Outlander. Chronicum?
Yes.
Oh, this is where I was. Oh! I got in here. Now you're sleeping here? Was he in here before? Hi.
Now, if it isn't the prodigy, well?
Lashari performed the ritual on me. There were problems in old Rationgrad.
Yes, I know. She's already told me everything. Good work. Even though part of her report seemed to be a bit enthusiastic. But I'll leave the judgment to Arantheal. He wants to talk to you anyway. Seems you've caught his interest.
Arantheal. Tell me again, who exactly is this Arantheal?
Didn't I tell you that already? He's the highly esteemed, holy, grand master of the Order. Tealor Arantheal, son of Lorius the First, praised be his name. An old legend, risen from the dead, or something like that.
Fine. Where can I find him?
In the Emporium, the last building on the left side of the temple. Just tell the guard that Arantheal has asked for you, and they will let you in.
Okay.
Ah, yes. Before I forget, my dame Lucy has left a token of gratitude for you. It's your choice. Do you want a book, an old map, or a bag of pennies?
Huh. Okay, so the book is 2 learning points. Not a lore book, although I definitely would take it. Treasure map. Yeah, it's up to the learning points or the treasure map. I'm kind of curious what the treasure map could point me at. So the map looks good.
Very well. Now get a move on. I'm sure we'll talk again later.
Again. Did I ask him this stuff? Emporium. Tell me more about your order's history. Who are you exactly? How'd you come to be?
Oh, do you really need me to answer that? Just take a look around. There are all sorts of great historical writings on us here. We're a bunch of bloodthirsty heretics who followed Tealor Arantheal's deluded son into the war against the gods, who gloriously defeated us in the Battle of Zaramar. Naratzul was locked into an old tower, and those of us who remained cowardly fled into the Neremese Mountains, and have since then terrorized and plotted against the poor people of the civilized world by all means necessary. Oh, and did I forget to mention that we eat babies for breakfast? Well, now I have.
And you lived through all that?
Through most of it, yes. But I don't want to go into detail.
I think I do remember him saying that. Who in the temple is part of your order? I'm having trouble telling you apart. Is that a bigoted thing to say?
Oh, don't tell Lucy that. Altogether, it's her, Yuslan, me, and 2 acolytes. Yuslan is probably the most gifted entropist of the civilized world, and I doubt there's anyone who knows more about the Pyreans than Lucy.
Okay, he stopped moving his mouth when he was talking. And I had it right, Pyreans. I read that book a few days ago. Which part of Nerim are you from, exactly?
Oh, that's hard to tell. Most of the time I was with Narathzul's order, in the Kabeit Mountains. But when I was younger, I used to travel a lot, not only in Nerim. What about you? Which idiots did you have the misfortune to be raised by? The foolhardy rebels up north? The bootlicking pawns of the Chancellor in the Middle Realm? Or the fanatic, mask-wearing, cultist oafs down south.
The latter. Ostian, to be precise.
Ostian, I see. A beautiful piece of earth, actually. But these sodding cultists and their creator have done their best to make it a living nightmare. Truth be told, it was them who made me join Narathzul's fight against religion back in the days. I was a young traveling arcanist then. and wanted to make some money in Ostian's arena. Fight some rabid animals, oh, you know the story. I had heard a lot about Nerim South and imagined a place at the pulse of life, exotic music, adventure, beautiful women. But you know who greeted me when I reached the city gates?
Who? A demon?
Corpses. They burnt their skin off and then nailed them to crosses.
I was
there
close.
There were at least 50 of them. Men, women, children. And they were set up at the roadside like trees in an alley. It was atrocious. The smell of burnt meat everywhere. The screams of those who still lived and all of it only because some fool has decided that they had somehow acted against their god. I still dream of it sometimes. Well, that was when I declared war on religion. I was so sick of seeing people cutting each other's throats only because they project their own personal problems into some holy scripture or higher power. And that's not even the worst part. They're beyond reason. Why are you doing this, I asked them. Because my God told me to. What's left to say there? You can essentially justify anything with that logic. This is why this place makes me sick. We need the Order's manpower. They need our knowledge about the Piraeans, and we both do want the same thing, yes.
He just said Piraeans
before.
Philosophy
and freedom of thought are nowhere to be found. It's pathetic.
Definitely have a point. I could have swore he said Piraeans before, now he's saying Piraeans. Where is this supposed to lead? In fire. But is the problem really religion itself? Not the people who misuse it for their own ambitions?
Yes and no. On the one hand, yes, a happy person will most likely never become a murderer, no matter if he or she follows the teachings of this creator or some Quiranian philosopher. But if something happens to this person, hunger, fear, shattered dreams, a peaceful ideology can make all the difference. What is religion, after all? It's a guide to live life, a set of values. And even if it's just one line in the Holy Scripture that says, kill the infidels, how likely is it that a broken man will interpret it in a peaceful way? If you want a justification to spill blood, you will find it. If your religion was ambivalent to begin with, even better. There's a lot of discussion about that on Kira. And it drives me mad to hear people prattling on about how it's all a matter of interpreting the scripture in different ways. Blazes, if your ideology is so peaceful, why does it say, slayeth this, slayeth that, rather than just get along? It's pathetic.
Definitely have a point there. So in other words, a truly peaceful religion shouldn't have ambivalent parts at all?
Yes, go on. Try to justify a massacre like the one in Ostian with a philosophy that consists of only two principles and nothing more. Respect those around you, and killing is bad regardless of the motives. Good luck.
I think I've been through this before. But since I'm not sure, I'll keep going. But religion can do good, too. It gives people a sense of community. And without some sort of moral guide, people would just do what they want.
Oh, believe me, they do that anyway. Plus, if the only thing keeping a person from killing and robbing another one is the thought that some higher power will punish him for it, then that person wasn't a paragon of virtue to begin with.
True. Alright, well, I'm off to meet with... What's his name? What's her name? See ya.
Oh, you're here. I thought you were in the city.
No, the Archmagister ordered me back. Feels good to be here, to be honest. But the funerals... I could have done without them, though.
I don't doubt that. I still can't believe that really happened. Brother Yarrow, he was such a good man.
Hmm.
I don't think the Red Madness cares much about that.
Part of Something Momentous. Part 1. Constantine Firespark told me that I aroused the Grandmaster's interest, especially in regard of my abilities and my visions. He awaits me in the Emporium, the meeting room of the Sun Temple. Grandmaster Arantheal.
Probably not, no. I wonder how it happens, the infection.
What do you mean?
Well, the red eyes and the obvious madness only happen in the last stages of the disease. But what happens before that? And how? How can one tell someone else is afflicted?
Who is this person?
Why? Scared you've caught it, are you?
That is not funny. You know, I've had this feeling that there's something wrong with Yarrow for quite some time, long before it happened.
You don't say. His wife was murdered. Don't you think that would have thrown you out of balance, too? Path-abiding Enderalian or not?
That's not what I mean. Her death broke him, yes. But there was no hatred in him, only grief. The hatred only came shortly before he did it.
Sorry, but I don't really see what you're going at.
I'm just trying to say that, well, maybe we all should be careful. Maybe it was Yuro's grief, his instability, that made him susceptible to the Red Madness in the first place. But let the Flameling and the Apothecary find that out. I have to go now, brother. Walk blessed.
The Flameling?
What?
Who's the Flameling? Shrug. Quick! To the Emporium! Hopefully this person will be awake, regardless of the hour.
As if they'd ever listen to me.
This is holy ground, Outlander. You don't belong here.
I was invited to be here.
To send an entire division across the sea because of a suspicion is madness.
We need to find out who sent the mercenaries. This Pegast said that they were after the Signet Stone, and if they succeed in getting hold of it next time, then the Black Guardian alone knows how to stop the cycle.
The Black Guardian.
The cycle. Listening to you talk almost makes me forget that all this fuss here is merely based on some bad dreams you and your Neremese friends had.
The threat is real. Deny it as much as you like, but deep inside, you feel it as much as I do.
Tealor, this... You're a commander, and a commander doesn't care about feelings, but about facts. You have made this mistake before, Tealor, back then in Kira.
Natara, the mission will happen. I'm sorry.
Cut her off.
You have a visitor.
So, you are the prodigy everyone is talking about. Interesting. I am Tealor Arantheal, son of Lorius the First and Grandmaster of the Order, and I'm honored to meet you. What is your name?
Honored, wow. Thank you. Topaz, you wanted to see me?
Yes, and I will come straight to the point. You are here because I believe that you are special.
Oh, shucks.
Humanity faces a threat that needs to be stopped. And to achieve this, you are indispensable.
Hmm. Special? Indispensable? You're gonna make me... get conceited. I mean, you're talking about the Red Madness, aren't you?
Among other things, yes. I do not need to explain to you that the present situation on Veen is chaotic. The wars, the living dead, common people who are losing their minds, to name only the most obvious. What most people are not aware of is the connection between these events. You, however, have encountered it, as have I.
Hmm. the visions, so you know where they come from?
I do. And I will explain everything to you. What it means, who we are, and what your part in all of this is. Come, follow me. Maybe you already know who I am. My entire life, I served the gods who ruled Vin, until their death 2 years ago. What you probably do not know is that the one responsible for their death is my son, Narazul Arantheal. He hated the Lightborn because he believed that they That's robbed mankind of their right to freedom. So he strived to over... He found followers, formed an army and declared war on them, and thus on me, a servant of the Lightborn as well. It all ended in a battle 30 years ago, which Narazul won. He killed every single survivor except for me, and locked me in a dungeon on Nerim. I still do not know why he spared me.
So the Lightborn are really dead. If you, the Order of the Gods, acknowledge that fact, why do people not know about it?
Good question. Because at the moment, stability is the highest good. Even more so, considering what we are facing. The rulers of Kira and Kile both made the mistake to acknowledge the death of the gods to their people, and the civil wars that followed in their countries are evidence of the chaos that such a revelation entails. Enderal is the cradle of the Order of the Gods, the epitome of theocracy. It is unthinkable what would happen if we confirmed these rumors. I am sure you understand this. Maybe when all this is over, that will change. But for now, it is imperative that we deny all rumors of that kind.
Lies. Wonderful. But I suppose necessary. If Narazul was your son, why did he hate the gods so much? Shouldn't he have been, I don't know, devoted to them?
There were circumstances favoring the development. But it's a long story, which we won't discuss now.
Oh, I want to know. But anyway, you managed to free yourself.
Yes, after more than 30 years, when the death of the gods made the magic around the prison disappear. And during my escape in the northern mountains of Nerim, I also had them for the first time. The dreams.
The dreams. I still have to look at this treasure map.
I always saw the same terrible light. Heard screaming, and I felt like I was burning up from the inside. And above all, like a veil, the knowledge of imminence. At first, of course, I dismissed these dreams as the delusion of a man close to death. So I concentrated on making it through the mountains somehow. 2 days after my escape, I was completely exhausted, and I would have died if a former acolyte of my son had not found me.
An acolyte of your son? But weren't they your enemies then?
Yes, but he did not recognize me, and brought me to their headquarters instead, an old monastery in the mountains.
Wow.
The others were aware of my identity, but for whatever reason they did not kill me.
Must have been awkward, though.
Maybe because they thought that the death of the Lightborn had made me insignificant. I do not know. Still, even after my recovery, the dreams come. At first, I doubted my sanity. But after some time, I told the mages, Constantine, about them. And he said something that I'd never expected. I was not alone. He, as well as many others magically gifted on Vin, dreamed the same dreams. And the more we talked about the matter, the stronger our suspicion grew, which has now turned out to be the truth. Oh. Dreams. They come from the same place. They are a shared memory.
What same place? A shared memory? You mean the dreams originate from a common mind?
A collective subconscious, yes. I really? Know that you can feel it too, and probably far more intense than we do. But like you back then, we were not able to make sense of the images. So we went looking for answers in the remains of the civilization that was before us, the Pyreans.
Right. Now he says Pyreans. So, thus the excavations, like in old Rationgrad. What did you find out?
Three things.
Three things?
First, there were many civilizations before us and before the Pyreans. Maybe hundreds, maybe thousands. Second, the history of each civilization unfolded and still unfolds according to a pattern. They emerge, they blossom, and at some point, peaks of their existence, they simply disappear without any trace. And third, everything that has happened in the past years and which is still happening indicates that this disappearance lies ahead of us. We are part of an eternal loop, a cycle, and our cycle is approaching its end.
Uh-oh. We have more here. Okay, so this doesn't advance it, the narrative. So this is your explanation for the Red Mantis? The wars?
Yes, dramatically put, they're the envoys of the end.
And a pattern. You mean that the chronicles of each civilization are identical?
Not identical, but one can split them up into episodes which repeat themselves in the very same manner, into patterns.
I admit that this world has seen brighter days, but isn't this a little too much of a leap? That this is the end of the world, or the end of humanity?
I see why you would say that, and I felt the same way for a very long time too. But there came a moment when we simply could not deny it anymore. We began to study the history of the Pyreans more intensely, and the parallels were extraordinary. In its early days, the Pyrean Empire was split up by a disaster, just like Vin was split up by the Starfall after the reign of the Eterna. Also, the Pyreans had a ruling caste who declared themselves gods after the catastrophe. The two castes of the Sun Priest. They, too, ruled until they were overthrown. This overthrowing was followed by an outbreak of wars and chaos, and then, just like that, the Pyreans ceased to exist. They knew it was imminent, but they could not prevent it. They called this event the Cleansing.
How the hell can an entire civilization just disappear like that?
That is the question we need to find an answer to. The end was not violent, at least not in a sense as we know it. There was no natural disaster, no magical explosion, no plague. Even though there was war in the Pyrean Empire before its ruin, when the cleansing happened, it was as if all living beings simply fell down and died. It is ghastly.
Damn. So the Pyreans knew about the threat? Didn't they try to do something about it?
They tried, but they failed. Who knows why? Maybe they found out too late, or maybe they were too weak.
And where do I come in? Where do these visions and my powers come from?
Well, this is the reason why we need your help. Not only episodes of history recur within every cycle, characters do as well.
Characters recur?
Yes. The Pyreans call them the Emissaries. They emerge very shortly before the cleansing occurs, like a law of nature, an answer to the Red Madness. and I am one of them, as are you. While I take on the role of the ruler, you take on the role of the prophetess.
I'm supposed to be a prophet?
It's just a description. Call it what you will. But without doubt, it is the truth. Your story matches the descriptions perfectly.
What descriptions? Okay, that's my question, but we have other things here. I'm wondering what descriptions, but if I choose this one, then these options will most likely go away. And why me, of all people?
I do not know. Firespark the Mage has told me your story. And even though your fate is tragic, unlike me, you were insignificant before your change. So maybe everyone can become an emissary, or we simply have not understood the pattern yet.
If I play a role, does that mean that something is controlling me? Controlling us?
No. As I already said, the emissaries simply appear at the beginning of the end, like pieces on a chessboard. We are determined by our skills. How and to what end we use them is our choice.
So I take it this is the reason the Naramis mages are here? Firespark, Pegast, Sharim?
Yes. Former enemies or not, both sides have understood the magnitude of the threat. The magical knowledge of Narazul's former mages is vast, as is the power of the Holy Order. Even though not all of the Keepers agree, as you probably have already noted yourself.
Okay, so what defines this prophet? What do I have in common with this description of a prophet?
On the one hand, your power. You carry the potential to master any skill within a fraction of the usual time needed. I assume you have already realized this. On the other hand, your ability to look into the past, and therefore, into the future.
Into the past, and therefore into the future? What do you mean?
Your visions are a window into the past. And as every cycle is based on the same events, it is a window into the future as well. You can feel the thread this world is woven with. And because of that, you can see things that have happened, and thus will happen again. This gift makes you indispensable to us, and it is why I want your help.
Why do you think we can overcome this cycle in the first place, after hundreds of civilizations before us have failed?
That is the wrong question. The correct question is, what alternative do we have? To wait and die?
What's in it for me if I help you?
If it is wealth and power you seek, you will have it. The Order has enough of both.
And if all this just doesn't interest me? That's a foolish thing. Like, as if my life doesn't interest me, but I want to see what he would say.
Hollow words. Deep inside, you know your responsibility.
I know.
Trust me, we are more alike than you believe.
All right, if I can help, I will try to do so.
Good. However, there's one more thing before the actual work begins. I want you to join our order, and to do so, you have to pass a test, a trial.
Oh boy. Join your order? Is this really necessary?
It is. Whatever you think about our story, we are the only faction that is strong enough to oppose the cycle. If you want to be part of our mission, you need to have access to our knowledge and resources. There will be voices in the Order speaking against your admission, as they are speaking against the presence of the Naramese mages. Consider it an honor or a necessity. It is up to you.
All right, what kind of test?
It is the trial the novices have to pass in order to be exalted to the role of a keeper. Only the best students of the squalor are allowed admission, and even though you have not been a novice, I want you to take it too.
A squalor? I looked around in there.
At this very moment, two novices are on their way to the testing grounds. I have informed them about your arrival.
You've already informed them. How could you know that I'd agree?
I had a hunch. Let us leave it at that.
Who are the two novices?
I have only a slight acquaintance with them. However, I know that they are both very talented and have been working hard toward the test. But see them for yourself.
Very well. Where can I find them?
At the border to the Heartland, near the Whisper Wood. They will be waiting for you there. Take the Myret, talk to Signet Master Bartar, and hand him this package. And then follow his orders. Ah, one more thing. It might be self-evident, but keep your knowledge about the death of the Lightborn to yourself.
Right.
I do not believe you can do any real harm. But in the worst case, path-abiding people will consider you a heretic. After the cycle has been stopped, we will deliberate upon how we deal with the matter. If and how we tell our people about it. But not now, that is for sure. Now, leave. The sooner we can dispense with this formality, the better.